I'm Jim Neubauer, and this is your safety moment. This is part two of Safety Data Sheets Explained. Section 2 is a mandatory section according to 29 CFR 1910-1200 Appendix D. In this section, hazards are classified and pictograms are used for identifying those hazards. If other hazards may be identified, those are listed here as well. If other chemicals with acute or unknown toxicity may be present, then that information can be found here as well. Section 2 is broken down into four different lines. The first line is a classification of a chemical in accordance with paragraph D of 1910-1200. In this line, manufacturers evaluate chemicals and classify or categorize them. Employers who use the chemical as intended by the manufacturer or choose not to do so are required to do their own evaluation. This includes all the chemicals in the mixture. Manufacturers can use available data for individual chemicals based on reasonable assumptions on the combined hazards. The second line in this section is signal word, hazard assessments, symbols, and precautionary statements. In accordance with paragraph F of 1910-1200, hazard symbols may be provided as graphical reproductions in black and white or the name of the symbol, flame, skull, and crossbones. There are only two words used in all classes of hazards. They are danger and caution. Danger is the more severe of the hazards, and caution is the lesser of the two terms. A hazard statement describes the nature of the hazards of the chemical, including the degree of the hazard, and are specific to the hazard classification categories. End users should always see consistent hazard statements, no matter what the chemical is or who produces it. All the applicable hazard statements must appear in the label, although they may be combined to reduce redundancies and improve readability. There are nine symbols of pictograms. They are health hazards, flame, exclamation mark, gas cylinder, corrosion, exploding bomb, flame over a circle, environmental, which is non-mandatory, skull and crossbones, the third line in this section describes any hazards not otherwise classified that have been identified during the classification process. OSHA defines these as adverse physical or health effects identified through evaluation of scientific evidence during the classification process that does not meet the specified criteria for the physical and health hazard classes addressed in this section. This could be due to an extremely low potential for risk. This can be broken down into two categories: physical hazards not otherwise classified, otherwise known as PHNOC, and health hazards not otherwise classified, HHNOC. The final line in this section, where an ingredient with unknown acute toxicity is used in a mixture at a concentration of less than 1%, and the mixture is not classified based on testing of the mixture as a whole, a statement of X percent of the mixture consists of an ingredient of unknown acute toxicity is required. This part, simply put, allows a manufacturer to state that a chemical is present that has not been evaluated and is present at a certain percentage of the volume. As an example, this product contains less than 1% of dihydrogenated oxygen. Call Exceed Safety for more information or to schedule your HAZCOM training class today. Exceed Safety and Tim Neubauer are restricted by a non-compete in some geographic areas and clients until May 4th of 2023. Please call for more information. I'm Tim Neubauer, and this has been your safety moment.
Exceed Safety, the consulting you need. Exceed Safety, expectations exceeded. So call 919-728-SAFE.